Ciao Felice.
Buongiorno Thomas.
How is everything?
Perfetto, tutto perfetto.
Tutto perfetto?
Tutto perfetto, direi.
Did you have a nice rest on your day off?
Yes, just travel day. Solo viaggio, un giorno di viaggio, travel day.
Uh-huh.
And then this morning here to montare tutto, per montare
okay.
tutto.
Ciao Davide.
Ciao Thomas.
We have here Wil Malone. Who is, of course, Gianna's producer and an arranger. And also, I'm afraid to say, an excellent drummer. Of course, that makes it very difficult for me to be in the band at all. Wil is here on stage with you. Is there anything you can tell me about the venue tonight, about the general quality of sound?
I think you could sum it up in one word.
Yeah, shit.
Okay.
Or as we say, so shite.
Is it shite? The band is more shite than the sound. Is that?
It's difficult to decide.
Okay. Of course, what do you think about the general hairstyles in the band?
Well, you know, the one I prefer is yours.
Mine?
Yes, because as you can see, Thomas has an haircut.
I got a haircut. Yes.
And it looks a little bit like Fonzie, you know, from Happy Days.
Of course, so. Yes.
Yes.
Okay, you know, I have to admit that, of course, my performance here in the band is not very good, so I don't really deserve to get paid in money.
Exactly.
But Gianna offered
a haircut
for the whole tour. So Gianna's stylist was kind enough to give me a haircut.
Yes, because it sounds like...
Which stylist?
Which one? Which hair?
Which hair?
Because, you know, sounds like a shit, but at least it looks great.
Oh, yes, exactly.
This is the name of the game.
And since this is show business, it's always more important to look good than to sound good.
Yes.
Is that so?
Every time.
I think
every
we agree on that.
Every time.
Okay, great. See? There you go. I represent the amateurs in the band. There are some professionals like Davide and Francis, and I'm a total amateur.
How long have you been playing the drums?
I have been playing now. Production rehearsal started about, I think, 2 weeks ago, so it's been about 2.5 weeks.
Okay, how do you manage to make your hands move independently?
I don't think I do manage that, actually.
I know there's a lack of that.
Yeah, there's a lack of that. I'm very good at that.
A new style.
That's my style and my trademark, lick, if you like. I see a lot of other drummers manage to play independently with arms and legs. I want to be different. And I want to coin my own sort of style, you know, and establish my own. That's why I play everything at the same time, always. All four limbs and hands at the same time.
Yes, and occasionally I've noticed you put in an extra beat in the bar.
Yes, I do that.
Sometimes a half beat.
Because, you know, there is really sophisticated music, and then there's music for people on the dance floor. I don't think the people on the dance floor are my friends. I don't want to make any friends on the dance floor. That's why I keep it interesting.
Purely technical.
And every once in a while, I add a note here and there, or take some out, and that also enforces and provokes interplay between me and the other musicians, because they have to really listen to it.
When people are dancing, and you put in an extra half beat, you find that they fall over occasionally?
I find that they fall over.
And that amuses you?
Yes, absolutely. I think it's beneath us as serious musicians to have people dancing. We want to stop them from dancing, that's why we do this.
That's right, I understand. This is why I cannot tap my foot when you're dancing.
That's the reason, see? Yeah. You're good. You hear that.
I do hear that. Yeah.
Is there anything you could... I mean, I'm a rookie. I've only been in the business for 3 weeks.
I would stop.
You think?
I would quit. Sell the kit, as it's not yours.
Yeah.
Make a profit.
Make a little bit of money. Yeah.
And take up maybe decorating.
Is that good? Do you have any experience with that?
I think it's better for... you don't have to coordinate.
I can just use one roller
one
and go up and down. A bit like I play the drums, basically.
Pretty much.
I might be... That might be my calling, actually.
Painting and drumming for weddings, maybe?
Painting is a bit like... Or drumming is a little bit like painting in the air, isn't it? I always imagine when I play the drums that I have got two giant paintbrushes and I'm drawing, you know, surreal, psychedelic pictures in the air.
It's a post-ironic East Chicago punk.
Exactly. You took the words out of my mouth. That's exactly what I was thinking of. Yes. Wow.